This is my screen capture of my project. The project that I chose to do is on a web quest, and we'll go through that in a little bit, and the link to the web quest will be available in the description for this video. But let's go to the explanation here. Introduction, I'm Xander Green. I work at Rosewood Elementary in Sandy Hill Elementary in Jemison, teaching first and sixth grade, first through sixth grade general music. Next semester, I will be at Creekside Middle in Zeeland, teaching sixth through eighth grade vocal music. As far as diversity background goes, currently I have pretty much a very, very overwhelming population of Caucasian Christian students. To my knowledge, I have one Jewish student, I have one African American student, and I have three or four Asian American students. The project I chose to do is involving notating different rhythm and melody patterns using the notation software Finale Notepad, which is the cheaper version of Finale. It's around $10 for it, and you can do basic notation in it. I chose this because I think it's valuable for students to know how to use this tool when they're in music. It also makes it so they don't have to hand write out music, and it offers an alternate way to do some stuff for older kids who are in your music classes. They can be a little bit more expressive. So as I said, I designed a web quest. What this web quest is, it's going to take you through how to use the notation software, Finale Notepad. So we'll go into the web quest a little bit here. Here's your home page. Notating rhythm and melody. So we'll go over the introduction, just do a little bit of rundown of everything. Just a brief description about what rhythm and melody are, what they do, why they're important to music, all that good stuff. Here's the task. The task will be for them to write four phrases that are two measures long of rhythm patterns and two measure long melodies, so eight phrases in total. Here's the process, the way they'll do that. I typed out all of the steps for them to go through in order to use Notepad. I also made this video, which is available on the website of the webcast. It's on YouTube as well. And you can see it play a little bit, go through. It's just setting up a document or a Finale. Pretty basic. I talked through how to use the different entry modes for Finale. So how are we going to evaluate them in my web quest? Well, I kind of did it like a solo and ensemble rubric would be. So for those of you who aren't in music or aren't really sure what that is, you get rated on a 5-point rating, one being the best, five being the worst. So the criteria is the same, just gets lower the lower numbers you get, and then there's some room for comments here as well. Conclusion's pretty simple, just a little bit of wrap-up. Why is this important? All that jazz. A little bit about what went into this. They should know the standards. Like, all that. That's the web quest. As I said, the goal was for them to have to write their own rhythm and melody patterns. It's important to me that they know how to do that, because that is the foundations of songs and music, is melody and rhythm. Notes make the music. And usually I would have them handwrite this. This was designed kind of for like an 8th grade general music class. But since the software is available, I figured we'll use it in the software, because it's a good tool for them to know how to use, and it's quickly becoming an industry standard, just using software like that to write with. Fonelli and Sibelius are the two big ones. Through this process, I had known a little bit about what a web quest was, what it's supposed to accomplish, all that, but now I really know what goes into setting one up and what some steps are, and there's still some more to learn about that. Also, how to use screen recording software. I'd used some before that was different than this program. This is a lot better than what I was using. I used to record myself for Twitch TV playing the game Magic the Gathering online. So this is a much better way to do that. And I also learned really how to make technology a key focus in my lessons, because it's not something you really think about when you're setting up a lesson. And there's technology that's used in music that could be loosely defined as like instruments and all that that I think about and put in, but never like sitting them down, showing them how to use notation, music, all that stuff that's available. So there's a lot out there. In conclusion, I'd like to expand this idea to kids who are serious about continuing their music education. Using notation software will help with that. It gives them an additional outlet for them to be creative, and it lets me see that my students are understanding something a little bit more. It gives just like that piece of paper that administration so often wants to see, instead of me just hearing that they get it or whatnot. I can also see myself using WebQuests more, especially in the music room. I didn't really think it would fit for me until I tried it. It fits pretty well. There's a lot I can do with that, especially learning about composers and all that. That's a nice mix-up. And yeah, that's the end. So there we go.